Hi everyone, this is Dr. Deepak working as assistant professor from Department of Biotechnology of Dr. NGP Arts and Science College. Today we are going to discuss one important topic from microbiology, that is bacterial classification. So in this video lecture, you are going to learn about the basic fundamental concepts of bacteria and their classification, gram staining, principle and procedure, result interpretation of gram staining and applications of gram staining. So bacteria is a minute living organism which can be able to see with the help of microscope, and it cannot be able to see with human naked eye, and they are termed as unicellular organism. Unicellular organism means they are containing only single cellular organisms. They are made up of single cellular, so it is known as unicellular organism. And they are belonging to prokaryotic group. So prokaryotic group means pro means very first. Karyon means nucleus. So to all together, the nucleus like material, very first formed nucleus in the world. So the bacterial organisms are containing nucleus like material. So these organisms are grouped under prokaryotic type. So these organisms are lack of few organelles which are found in the higher organisms. If you take plant or animal, there are multicellular organelles are present. For example, nucleus, chloroplast, mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes and so on, lysosomes, peroxisomes, etc. There are many organelles are found to be present in higher organisms like plant and animals. So those organelles are found to be absent in bacteria, and especially true nucleus was absent in the bacterial species. And coming back to the classification of living organisms, many different scientists have proposed the concepts of our living organism classification. Among them, R.H. Whittaker, in the year of 1969, he proposed the five kingdom concept. According to him, the organism was classified into five different groups. They are Monera, Protista, Plantae, Fungi and Animalia. So under the group of Monera, the bacterial species was classified. The organisms which are containing less organelles and also which is lack of true nucleus, those organisms are classified under Monera. And single cellular eukaryotic organisms are classified under Protista. And the organisms which produce its own food, those are classified under Plantae. And yeast, mold and mushrooms, these like organisms are classified under Fungi. And the organisms which involved in decomposing of the materials, biomaterials, those also categorized under the kingdom Fungi. And Animalia, the organisms which are depends on another organism for food purpose, those are categorized under Animalia. And coming back to the bacterial classification. So bacteria can be classified into various categories based on various features of the bacteria. So it can be classified based on shape and based on the chemical composition present in the cell wall and based on the mode of respiration, how the organism involved in respiration and mode of nutrition. These are all the some of the important categories that is used for the bacterial classification. The first one is based on shape. So according to bacterial classification, based on shape, the bacteria are classified into different category. They are shape and rod and spiral and comma. So comma shaped bacteria are termed as vibrios. Spiral shaped bacteria are popularly renowned as spirilla, and rod shaped bacteria are regarded as bacilli, and spherical shaped bacteria are classified as cocci. And based on the cell wall composition, the chemical present in the cell wall, based on the cell wall, the bacteria are classified into gram positive and then gram negative. You can see in the picture, in the gram positive bacteria, on the surface of the cell wall, the first layer is made up of a thick layer of peptidoglycan. So whereas in gram negative, the first layer of the cell wall, which is made up of phospholipids, phospholipids are present. Here a thin layer of peptidoglycan layer was found below the phospholipid layer. So this is the chemical differences between the gram positive and gram negative bacteria. So this chemical differences makes different results in the gram staining procedure that we will discuss in the upcoming slide. And based on the respiration, the bacteria are classified into two types, that is aerobic and anaerobic. So aerobic means the organisms which requires the presence of oxygen. For the growth, for the development, for the living nature, the organism completely require the presence of the oxygen. Those conditions, those organisms are termed as aerobic organisms. And next one is anaerobic. So anaerobic means absence of oxygen. The organism which does not require the presence of oxygen. If oxygen is present, the organism was unable to sustain. So those kind of organisms are termed as anaerobic organisms. Among the two different types, there are other subtypes also there, that is obligate and facultative. So obligate organism means they can sustain the presence or absence of the oxygen. But the facultative organisms are completely require the specific conditions. That organisms are classified under facultative organisms. And based on the nutrition, bacteria can be classified into majorly two types, that is phototrophs and heterotrophs. And among the phototrophs, there are different types of bacterial classification was formed. We can see one by one. So first one is chemical and light. So based on the chemical, so if the bacteria utilizes the chemical components that is present in the environment, those are known as chemotrophs. The organism which utilizes chemicals which is presently available in the environment on the earth, surface of the earth, if it is utilizing, means that organisms are grouped under chemotrophs. And if the organism is producing its own food by consuming light, carbon dioxide and then water, those organisms are categorized under phototrophs. And the chemotrophs, those are further classified into hemoheterotrophs, hemoautotrophs. So hemoheterotrophs means the organisms utilizes organic compounds, carbon containing compounds, those are classified as hemoheterotrophs. If the organism is utilizing carbon dioxide from the environment, it is termed as chemoautotroph. So similarly, under phototrophs, the organic compounds was utilized means the phototrophic organisms are further classified as photoheterotrophs. And if it is utilizing carbon dioxide for the production of food, it is termed as photoautotrophs. And the examples were given in the picture. And coming back to the staining. So staining is an important technique which is used for classifying the bacteria. So till now we have seen the bacterial classification, how the bacteria was classified from one another. And now on we are going to see about an important technique which utilizes the classification, which is used for classifying, differentiating the bacteria. Basically, the staining procedure is used to highlight the bacteria. Bacteria cannot contrast by nature. Naturally, the bacteria cannot contrast. So to produce a contrast image of bacteria, the staining technique was used. So staining is nothing. The chemical dye is used to color the surface of the cell wall or the bacteria so that the bacterial structure and ultrastructure of the bacteria can be visualized under microscope. So it is used for understanding the chemical composition or the surface or ultrastructure of the bacteria. Basically, the stain is made up of positive ion or negative ion. So the microbial cells, as I said earlier, the microbial cells are lack of contrast. It is necessary to use to observe their detailed structure and to identify them. For that purpose, the staining is very useful to study the important functions of the microorganisms. So among the different staining method, Gram staining method is a fundamental staining process which differentiates the bacteria into Gram positive and Gram negative. So this Gram staining is a very important and common technique which was discovered or introduced by a Danish bacteriologist, that his name is Hans Christian Gram. So to honor his invention, the technique was named as Gram staining. So this technique was discovered in the year of 1884. So with this technique, the bacteria were classified into Gram positive and Gram negative bacteria. So the principle of Gram staining. So in this technique, the bacteria was stained with crystal violet and then fixed by mordant. So mordant here is a crystal. Gram's iodine is used as a mordant, and then the after onwards the bacteria was decolorized with 70% ethanol or acetone, and after onwards counter stain, that is safranin, was used to stain the bacteria. So this is the process of Gram staining procedure. So during this process, the crystal violet and Gram's iodine will form CVI complex. CVI bond, the chemical bond will be formed between crystal violet and iodine. So that CVI complex was formed and it was attached onto the surface of the cell wall. And the cell walls of Gram positive bacteria are containing high amount of phospholipid layer, that is peptidoglycan layer was present. A thick layer of peptidoglycan was found on the surface of the Gram positive cell wall. In case of Gram negative, upon the peptidoglycan layer, the phospholipid contents were present. So this is the difference between Gram positive and Gram negative. So this makes an important thing in the Gram staining procedure, because during the decolorization, the Gram positive bacteria was unable to release the CVI complex. In case of Gram negative bacteria, the thick content of the phospholipids was denatured by decolorizing process. So during the decolorization process, the ethyl alcohol was interacted with the lipid content of the Gram negative bacteria, so that the lipid content was eliminated and then CVI complex also eliminated, and the counter stain safranin was retained by the Gram negative bacteria. In case of Gram positive bacteria, the CVI complex was tightly retained, because here the decolorization does not affect on the cell wall composition, so that the safranin was unable to stain on the surface of the Gram positive bacteria. So this is the principle of Gram staining procedure. And coming back to the reagents that is used in the Gram staining, so there are some reagents that is useful for the Gram staining process. They are crystal violet, that is act as a primary stain, very first used stain, so it is called as primary stain, and iodine, it is a act as a mordant. It reacts with the primary stain and forms CVI complex. And then a decolorizer. So for decolorizer, we can use alcohol, that is 95% alcohol, or acetone we can use as a decolorizing agent. And then safranin is used as a counter stain. So for determining the Gram negative bacteria, safranin is very useful. And procedure of Gram staining. For performing the Gram staining, a clear glass slide should be taken. So on the surface of the glass slide, a bacterial smear should be prepared. A 24-hour old bacterial smear has to be prepared. On the surface of the bacteria should be heated and air dried. It has to be heat fixed and air dried first. And then after onwards, on the surface of the bacteria, the crystal violet, a drop of crystal violet was added. After keeping it with some time, it was rinsed with water and followed by Gram's iodine was added, and it was retained for 1 minute and washed with clean water. And after onwards, the slide was washed with 95% alcohol or acetone for 10 to 20 seconds. And then it was rinsed with water, and finally the safranin, a few drops of safranin was added and kept for 1 minute, and then the slide was washed with water. After onwards, the slide was allowed to air dry and blotted with the tissue paper and observed under microscope. So if the Gram positive bacteria was taken, it will be observed as purple or blue in color. In case of Gram negative bacteria, it appears in pink in color. The counter stain, that safranin, was retained by Gram negative bacteria. So finally, the Gram negative bacteria appears in pink in color. So this is how the results can be observed under microscope. If the Gram positive bacteria is being observed under microscope, means upon Gram staining procedure, the Gram positive bacteria will look like blue or purple in color. In case of Gram negative, the bacteria will appears in red in color. And the applications: to identify the unknown bacteria, if we need to identify the bacteria which is isolated newly from the environmental sample like soil or water, the Gram staining procedure is the first step to classify the bacteria. And Gram stain is a cost effective method. The Gram staining procedures are cost effective to screen the clinical specimens. So presently there are many diseases are coming, new forms of diseases are coming. So to identify the clinical specimens, the Gram staining procedure is very useful to classify the bacteria. And to understand, to study the internal structures of the microbes, the Gram staining is the preliminary and very first procedure to understand the structure of the bacteria. And thank you.